as I promised to you before the commercial break, I am going to talk about the future now. Let's talk about the future. I've all done the past. So, you're young people, and it's very interesting, very interesting conversation that we had so far, and very inspiring as well. Tell us where you see yourselves in 10 years from now. Let's start from Lakshita, since he has the most vibrant dreams. Yes, Lakshita, where do you see yourself?
As I said, I want to be on a newspaper saying the first Sri Lankan to be a CEO in a Fortune 100 company.
Let's say
that's where I dream to be. So I'm sure that I'll go there.
Yes,
I'll make sure that I'll go there.
Now you have transformed into Man of Steel. That's good. Inspiration helps. Yes, Hiruni.
I will definitely. I'll obviously hopefully be married,
yes,
and have my own children.
Mm.
I'm definitely planning to start my own thing. So it won't be a big business or anything like that. It'll be something very small, because I like this fashion designing and stuff also. So it might be something to do with that, or something to do with dancing or something. I don't know. It'll be something very small, but it'll, because I need to, you know, have that as well as balance my
family life. Yes.
So that's where I see myself.
Well, you know, Lakshita, you don't want to have a family life, is it?
I do have a family life.
You never mentioned it until you really said it. So I was wondering.
No, what is there to mention? I'm now a family man, and I will be a family man forever.
Okay.
So, where I go. Yeah.
I'm sorry?
No. Wherever I am, I'll be the same family man.
Yes, amazing. Okay, so now tell us about what you can educate the young audience out there about.
Mm-hmm.
What can you tell them? In order to be motivated, like you said, Hiruni, I remember that you said that you motivated yourself by collecting bits and pieces of inspiration from different people in different areas, different arenas.
Mm.
And Lakshita also said that, you know, transcending from one area to another, you did not give up, you did not sort of be hanky-panky about it, and you just went on, head on. And so, what sort of advice do you give the young ones out there who want to aim high like you both?
One thing is, be determined, be so determined, and be focused, and dream high, so you will go there. Make sure that you will go there. It will make you go there.
Okay.
So being determined is the key.
Okay.
And another thing is, I guess you shouldn't give up, you know, whatever obstacles come, whatever challenges that come your way, you should never give up, and, you know, and have like a set few objectives, set few goals.
Exactly. So
that, you know, some, you know, achievable, and some maybe not, you know, maybe you think those are not achievable, but make sure that you have them, so that one day you will actually get there. So, and like I think Lakshita also mentioned this, you know, it's your youth that will never come again. And that's the time that you can actually do a lot of things, you know, go out there, crazy stuff. It may be crazy, but still you have to achieve.
Yeah.
So it's this time period that you need to achieve so much of things.
Yeah.
So don't give up, you know, don't look back or think of any challenges or anything like that. You know, there may be, I mean, sometimes you can say, I don't have time these days, you know, I don't know what to do next. And so you should basically just let go of all those boundaries, and, you know, let go, and restrictions, anything, just break it off and go and get it.
Now, there's an old saying that you won't be old and wise if you're not young and crazy.
Young and crazy, exactly.
So both of y'all are young and crazy, and I can see that. Alright, so being young and crazy and being so involved in your and passionate in your streams and in your work, tell us now, how do you balance your personal lives and your career? Akshita?
Yes, it's been really busy past couple of years after getting into the job and everything, but you should balance it. Otherwise, there'll be one day that you would probably regret that I didn't do this
exactly
for my family, I didn't do this for my family. So you have to make sure that you have a proper balance, no matter what things that you're involved in, no matter how busy you are, you have to really make sure that you dedicate some time for family and other important stuff, because those people won't be there forever.
So
you have to make
sure. And what are the tips that you can give young people out there in order, like, I mean, personally, what kind of things that you follow?
One thing that I've seen is, more occupied you are, more efficient you are. Let's say you're very occupied and you're very busy. You make sure that you dedicate some quality time to that thing. let's say,
without being distracted.
Exactly. Mm. When you have more free time, you are not really bothered to dedicate that time. Mm-hmm. So, one thing that I've experienced is more occupied you are, more busy you are, you have that quality time dedicated for that thing.
Yeah.
So, let's say family, you have that time with family.
Of course.
So, that is one thing that I've experienced.
Yeah, I totally agree. Because I think, you know, being on your toes is something that will always keep you going.
Yes,
and
yes,
keep
yes,
you achieving, keep you achieving a lot of things.
Yeah.
So that is one thing. You need to make sure that, you know, your time is, you know, managed properly. And like you said, of course, you know, the proper time given for family, the proper time given for leisure. I mean, you should go on holidays as well, because that helps you relax your mind and, you know, refresh your thinking.
Mm.
So, you know, proper time given for proper exercise and stuff like that. I mean, I do yoga. I believe that it helps me to, you know, balance. I mean, when you're stressed out at work and all that, it really helps you. So that balance is definitely required. And even with work, I think one thing we see is that, I don't think even he's like that. We don't like to work late nights and, you know, just cram over our work.
Yeah.
Make sure that, you know, that days of work is done within that day on a specific time. And after that, you know, you go home, you spend your time with your family, other stuff. So those are things that you need to look out for. I mean, it's not just one area. If it's work, it's not just work.
Yes.
If it's studies, it's not just studies.
Yeah.
So, you know, allocate your time accordingly.
Yeah. And and it's very, I've also heard this, and I believe that after having the conversation with you, I believe it in more. I mean, if you find something that you're passionate about as work, you don't really have to worry about being stressed out.
Exactly.
Or being tired. I mean, you are having fun there,
exactly.
And then you can be very excited when you come home. So I'm sure that, you know, both of you share that view and that vision as well of balancing life, your personal lives and professional lives, and also being very passionate about what you're doing. So thank you so much, Hiruni and Lakshita, for joining us today. It was amazing talking to both of you, and I got very inspired. I'm sure that all our young audiences out there got very inspired as well. And congratulations once again. I hope that you will go out there with more victories for representing Sri Lanka. And thank you so much. And
thank you
very much.
Go out there and be the man of steel and woman of steel that you always wanted to be, and also create and mentor more men and women of steel.
Of course,
so we can be proud of.
Yeah. Definitely.
So thank you so much for joining us today, people out there. If you want to give us any feedback, any suggestions, comments, please log into www.facebook.com/goodmorningsrilanka and click like and add whatever you want to say about us on that page. Okay, we are going into It's Always a Good Time right now, and we will join you tomorrow, same time. We will see you tomorrow. Bye-bye. My clothes like I didn't care.